In this part, we'll be talking about vascular connective tissue. And in vascular connective tissue, we have two types of tissues. One is blood, other is lymph. We have already discussed blood in detail in the chapter of circulatory system, that is circulation of body fluids, in the unit of human physiology. But we'll quickly go over all the important points. So we'll take up blood first. So blood is a red colored liquid in case of human beings, and it is known as the liquid connective tissue. It is made up of two components, or there are two components of blood, that is plasma and the corpuscles. Plasma and corpuscles. Plasma makes about 55% of the blood, and corpuscles make 45% of the blood. Now we are talking about this plasma. Plasma has about 90 to 92% water, about 1 to 2% inorganic substances, which are mainly salts, 1 to 2% organic substances, and we add a special category, about 6 to 8% of proteins. Now, when we talk about organic substances, we have excluded proteins. Now, let us see what all these things have. That means, what exactly is this 6 to 8% of protein part? The proteins, they are generally termed as plasma proteins, as they are found in the plasma part. One is called albumin, or it is known as serum albumin. Then serum globulins, and third, clotting proteins. So these are three main types of proteins which are present in the plasma. Serum albumin is responsible for osmoregulation. Serum globulins are the immunoglobulins. Immunoglobulins, they provide immunity, they work as immunoglobulins, that is antibodies. And clotting proteins are two, that is fibrinogen and prothrombin. These two help in blood clotting. Amongst inorganic substances, we have various kinds of salts, ions, and there are certain other substances like urea, which is also in this. Mainly there is water. Plasma also contains, there are other substances which are intermediate compounds, and they can be these organic substances, like there is sugar. And the sugar is glucose, which is the blood sugar. Then there can be certain intermediate substances like lactic acid, which is produced in muscles but has to be taken to liver for further breakdown. And the blood or the plasma is the substance through which this lactic acid will be transported. So we might detect this lactic acid also in the plasma. So this is just a brief thing about plasma. Coming to corpuscles, three types of cells are present. One, RBC, that is red blood corpuscles. Then WBC, white blood corpuscles, and platelets. WBCs, RBCs, and platelets, the three main cells which are found in blood. RBC, in case of humans, that is in us, they are enucleated. In all other mammals, there are nucleated RBCs, and they are enucleated when they are mature. That means immature RBC is with all the structure. That means it has nucleus plus all organelle. But as it matures, it loses its nucleus and all other organelles so that the maximum space which is available can be provided to hemoglobin. And because of this enucleated nature, their shape becomes biconcave. Here is a depression which is there. The size is about 7.5 microns. And the number of RBCs, it varies in males and females. But the range is 4.5 to 5.5 million per cubic centimeter. This is the number of RBC and it is known as RBC count. The lifespan is 120 days. And what is present inside is hemoglobin. It is completely packed with the respiratory pigment hemoglobin. And its function is to transport respiratory gases. WBCs, two categories. Granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes and agranulocytes. In granulocytes, the cytoplasm is granular, where here the cytoplasm is smooth. In granulocytes, we have eosinophils, then basophils, and neutrophils. These are irregular in shape, and the nucleus, they are all nucleated, and the shape of the nuclei, they are also variable. Here it is bilobed, that is in acidophils or eosinophils, trilobed in case of basophils, and multilobed in case of neutrophils. The number of neutrophils is maximum amongst the WBCs. And agranulocytes are two, monocytes and lymphocytes. These are the two agranulocytes. They perform various functions, and as I said in the beginning, we have discussed their size, their percentage, their shape, and their functions in detail in the chapter of circulation. So, the third cell, that is platelet. Platelets are oval cells, and we find dense cytoplasm in the center, which is confused with a nucleus. But this is not a nucleus. That means platelets are also enucleated. They are without any nucleus and they are formed by fragmentation of the cells which produce platelets. Now these corpuscles, that means RBC, WBCs and platelets, they are produced in erythropoietic tissue, that is red bone marrow, and their number, their value is important. If it increases, then also there are complications. If the number goes down, then also it results into complications. Platelets, they help in blood clotting. They release a factor which is called the platelet factor, which initiates the process of blood clotting. So these three are the cells, that is, those are known as corpuscles, and there is plasma. So this is just to have a brief understanding of what all things are there in blood. And we have discussed all these points in detail. For example, in RBC, we have talked about each and everything. That is, which are the erythropoietic cell tissues, the hormone erythropoietin, where it is required, more number of RBC, the condition, less number. So, for the detail, you can watch the video which is in the chapter of circulation. The first liquid connective tissue or vascular connective tissue is blood. Now in the next part, we'll take up the other vascular tissue, that is